All right, this video's got a couple of purposes. First, I'm trying to use my phone instead of the camera, instead of my camcorder. And got it mounted slightly different. It's straight on rather than looking over my shoulder. Secondly, as part of that test, I'm going to do sort of a kit build. This is one of these 8x8 LED grids driven by this Mac 7219. And it's a pretty simple little thing to put together. You got two capacitors, a resistor, the chip in a socket, so that you, and of course the LED grid itself. And one thing I've discovered by looking at these online is the only real thing you have to be careful about, well, two things. One, getting that guy in the right orientation, because it will fit that way or that way, but electrically it has to go this little nub here like that. There's the pin one indication there. And this electrolytic capacitor, 10 microfarads. Positive goes up that way, negative that way. Because the LED matrix sits over top of it, it has to be mounted sitting like that so that the LED matrix can clear it. So, here we go. The capacitor is already in. A little 0.1 microfarad ceramic. They don't care, they can go either way. And it's shallow enough that it's not an issue. The 10K resistor, which obviously isn't a current limiting resistor. I don't know what it's doing, and I'm assuming it's just a pull-up or something for the Max chip, but it's really, this isn't one of those videos where I'll dissect the circuit and figure out what it is. I just want it to work. My trusty ancient Weller soldering iron that I've had since I was a teenager. Which was many, many decades ago. But it has served me well all these years. I suppose I could spend the money, get one of those fancy Heikos or the knockoff that everybody on YouTube seems to use, but why? This one works. Okay, how's that look? Flux is a little blobby, but nothing looks bridged, so that's good. Yeah, that's a little ugly. That resistor lead. Good thing I'm not doing this for money. Okay, chip next. Indentation mark there for pin one, indentation mark there for pin one. That's holding in there quite nicely. Just gonna do that just to make sure though. All Okay, and now the rest of them. Oh, hello. Focus. Sorry about that. I wasn't even paying attention. Guess that's one of the things I gotta figure out about using a different camera to do this. My camcorder that I had been using before just constantly autofocus wherever it thought it should. This one, I can manually focus. There, that was quick. And again, just take a quick peek here. Yeah, everything's got solder, no bridges. Okay, next, a socket for the LED matrix uses these cool turn pin headers rather than the cheesy ones like what the chip socket's made out of. The reason I'm soldering it with that in is just to make sure that the spacing and the parallelness is correct. Normally I don't like soldering stuff. Soldering stuff while it's socketed if I can avoid it, because I don't want the heat transfer or any theoretical potential static jumping up into the chip, although that's kind of unlikely on that LED board. Still, that's all these years of habit. Back when CMOS was super duper fragile and expansive. And I just keep doing it. Okay, once that's soldered up, now there's these 90 degree header pins for the data in and data out, and power in and out. Focus back down there. Now I see why Big Clive is constantly pointing that out. And just something you got to keep your head wrapped around. Okay. Dope. Did I miss one? I missed two. Okay, those are kind of blobby. Where'd my light go? Oh yeah, look at that, that's nasty. There, that's more like it. I wonder if I can zoom with this thing. Let's see. Oh, actually, I don't have to. I'll just bring it up here. So those are now nice little tent shapes rather than little spheres just sitting on the board. Go back down there. please always clean your tip. I'm using, trying out one of those, looks like just a kitchen scrubber pad, but it's theoretically made out of brass. Or some variant on chinesium. One of these things. I've only started using it a month or so ago. I had been using ye olde sponge that's as old as the soldering iron itself, possibly older. So now then, pin one is the little notch there, a little notch on the socket. Just lay in one side. Gently push the whole thing over, make sure they're aligned, squeeze them home, stab myself only slightly on the back. This guy now, pin one was down here. This tab indicates this side's the one that's got pin one on it. Done. Okay, let's load a demo sketch into an Arduino. Let's see what happens. Actually, I'm cheating. I've already done that. That's there. That's there. What do I need? Power. Oh. Ta-da! Yeah, I did another one earlier. That's grand. And how long did that take me? 12 minutes start to finish. Cool. I suppose it'd be polite of me to actually show the code that I used, even though it's incredibly ugly and pretty much completely hacked straight out of the demo script. So here's the demo script. Let's scroll to the top, shall we? Basically, this comes with the library, the LED control library. So it does it. It prints a nice little Arduino across the screen, but it only uses 5 characters, or 5 of the 8 columns. That's no good. So I ripped a chunk out of that. Complete with comments because I'm just lazy at copy and pasting. And I created 2 8 dot wide by 8 rows high patterns, just the X and the plus, and labeled them X and O just because that makes complete sense since I made an X and a plus. And so the first this first chunk here does the X, which is just the bits that you'd see. So 8 bits, the first column gets a 1, all the middle columns get a 0, gets a 1, that's the top row. Next row down, the 1 moves in. Next row down, the 1 moves in. Next row down, the 1's in the middle pair. And then back out again. And then wait half a second, and then the O, which is the plus sign, and again 1, 2, 3, 4 that are just 4 rows that are just the 1 dot, and then the cross piece across the middle, all ones, and then 4 more of these guys. Bidi 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 bidi, that's all, folks.